Dear students, welcome to DCE Digital Learning Program. In this video, we will be discussing about third semester physics, Mangalore University of fourth unit, that is radiation and lasers. In that first session, it is of session 37, we will be discussing. In this video, the objectives of the study are, first one is concept of black body and best approximation to the black body, Kirchhoff's law and its uses. First thing, there are some basic terms need to understand before understanding the concept. First thing is radiation. It is always question comes to mind, what is radiation? What are the properties of radiation? Is the radiation contains particles or the waves? So many questions comes to mind. Basically, it is the source of energy coming from any source, and they can travel through space. They don't require any medium, that is about the radiation. Electromagnetic radiation. Then what is electromagnetic radiation? It refers to the electromagnetic field propagating through the space. Electromagnetic spectrum. It is the range of frequencies of electromagnetic radiation. There are number of different type of electromagnetic waves. Completely they called as electromagnetic spectrum. It is the arrangement of electromagnetic waves with respect to wavelength or with respect to frequency, that is the meaning. Black body. One basic definition is, any body, if it absorbs all the radiations falling on it, then it is called as a black body. Practically, there is no availability of black body, but we can construct black body, or we can approximately construct any black body. Black body radiation. The radiation coming from the black body is called black body radiation. It is coming due to temperature variations. Whenever its temperature is rising by any means, it emits radiations. They are called as black body radiation. Here is the complete electromagnetic spectrum that you can observe. It is starting from radio waves. Suppose if we consider it from the wavelength, radio waves are of large wavelength, whose wavelength is very large compared to all other radiations. And next is the IR, that is infrared region, and next is the visible region. We can observe, we can differentiate the colors in the visible region. Our naked eye can be possible to recognize the light, so it is called as visible light. It is a small portion in the entire electromagnetic spectrum. If you observe that small portion, if you enlarge, you can observe different colors. It is about visible light. And next comes the ultraviolet region, next comes the X-rays, and next comes the gamma rays. So it is the arrangement, and it is very important to study electromagnetic spectrum during radiation studies. Why? Because different electromagnetic waves are of different energies. Energy is different for different type electromagnetic waves. When we see the energy point of view, the energy is very small for the radio waves, and it is increasing gradually, and it is maximum for gamma rays. Gamma rays are of very high energy. So whenever a black body or any body whose temperature is increasing by any external agency, they start emitting radiations. They are of different wavelengths. We can observe only visible light, but it emits other radiations also. All depends on the temperature of the black body. The emitted radiation whose energy variations all depends on the temperature of the black body. And here are some examples for the thermal bodies you can observe. Sun is of course a thermal body which emits radiations out. And volcanic eruptions emits radiations. Other examples you can observe. In all the cases, you can observe the radiations emitting out. You can differentiate what the color, what is the intense majority, maximum intensity radiation you can observe. And next concept is very interesting. I already told you that we cannot get an ideal black body. Ideal black body don't exist, but we can construct a black body practically which is near approximation to the ideal black body. It is here called as a Ferris black body. Ferris black body construction is the next topic, very interesting topic also. Here, what is the basic construction you can observe? Basically, it contains double walled sphere and one hole drilled on it at a point. The hole drilled to enter the incident radiations inside the black body. It is a double walled sphere. Inside it is coated with lamp black and outside it is a nickel coated. Two spherical layers and one pinhole is made in which the radiation enters inside the black body. There is one conical projection. It is used for the multiple reflections of the incident radiation and to avoid direct reflection of the radiation, entered radiation to the outside. It avoids direct reflection of the radiations to the outside. So that it undergo multiple reflections, entered radiation undergo multiple reflections inside the sphere. Repeatedly they collide with the walls and during each collision they absorb, the surface absorbs the lamp black that is coated inside, absorbs the incident radiation. Likewise, after a long period of time, all the entered radiations are absorbed by the lamp black coated inside the black inside the sphere, so it is acted like a black body and it obeys the properties of the black body. I already told you that black body absorbs all the radiations incident on it. Here the arrangement itself absorbs all the radiations enters into the sphere. Next, there are two definitions. One is emissive power and one is absorptive power. We know that any thermal body or any hot body emits radiations and they emit radiations in all the directions, not only in a particular direction, they emit radiations in all the possible directions. So we can measure the quantities. Likewise, we have two definitions. One is the emissive power. Definition is the radiations emitted per unit area of a surface in 1 second to the radiations emitted by a perfectly black body per unit area in 1 second. It is denoted by E lambda. So this is about emissive power. We considered one normal body and one perfectly black body. We are comparing the radiations emitted by those two bodies. With that information, we can define the emissive power. Then absorptive power. It is the ratio of amount of heat absorbed in a given time by the surface to the amount of heat incident on the surface in the same time. It is denoted by A lambda. Two simple definitions, you can understand it by reading or by hearing the words. Next is one important definition in radiation field given by Kirchhoff, that it states that the emissive power to the absorptive power for radiation of a given wavelength is the same for all bodies at the same temperature and is equal to the emissive power of a perfectly black body at that temperature. So this is the definition of Kirchhoff's law. Here E lambda, small e lambda, is the emissive power. We already discussed A lambda is the absorptive power and capital E lambda is the emissive power of a perfectly black body. There are two note points. These are very important for further discussion. First one is, just observe, if lambda and t, that is wavelength and temperature, is fixed in a given condition, the ratio is fixed, implying that E lambda is proportional to A lambda. Suppose at a particular wavelength and at a particular temperature of any body, E lambda is always proportional to A lambda. We know that E lambda is the emissive power, A lambda is the absorptive power. So it results that emissive power is proportional to absorptive power. In another way, we can say that good absorbers are always good emitters. Can interchange the definition also. Good absorbers are good emitters. Second one is, temperature radiation means the radiation coming out due to temperature variation only, not by any chemical action or by electric discharge. So this is very important. So we are dealing with the temperature radiation only. So Kirchhoff's law is applicable only for temperature radiations, the radiations coming from the body due to its temperature variations. Next one is the two important applications of Kirchhoff's laws in two fields, namely astrophysics and spectroscopy. Let us discuss in detail about each. First one is, in astrophysics, Fraunhofer lines, we called it as, you can observe a picture, the spectrum you can observe. See, it is the spectrum of sun, solar spectrum we can say. When we take the spectrum of a sun by using the arrangement or by using the spectrometer, we can observe the spectrum like that. Newton demonstrated the experiment and they considered the sun spectrum is continuous and sun is like a black body. They emit all the wavelengths. So it is like a black body, they discussed and they demonstrated it. Fraunhofer, after a certain time, period of time, repeating the same experiment, found that solar spectrum is not actually continuous, but it consists of large number of dark lines. These lines named as Fraunhofer lines. Fraunhofer lines are the dark lines in between the continuous spectrum of solar sun. Then a question, how the dark lines are created or observed in the continuous solar spectrum. We already considered it is the continuous. Why it is existing? The explanation given by Kirchhoff solved the problem actually. So one note point we already discussed, telling that good absorbers are always good emitters. So with that concept, we can explain clearly the existence of dark lines. Basically what happens is, Inside the solar, there is a core which emits basically continuous wavelength, so continuous radiations, wavelength radiations. So core is of a, is like a black body. It emits all the wavelengths, but the outer atmosphere consists some of the gases like hydrogen, nitrogen, sodium, cesium, copper, etc. They are basically at low temperature. So they require energy. Whenever they receive the energy from the core, they absorb the radiations of particular wavelengths. All the gases or various elements present outside the atmosphere absorbs the wavelengths of the radiations of particular wavelength. As a result, the radiation after coming from the atmosphere around the sun, when we observe through the spectrometer, those wavelengths which are missing, those wavelengths which are observed by the elements are missing in the spectrum. They appear as dark lines in the spectrum. So this is the reason for the existence of Fraunhofer lines in the continuous polar spectrum. Second one is the one more interesting thing, that sodium spectrum and sodium absorption and emission spectrum. We can see in the lab sodium emission spectrum, sodium vapor lamp. When we observe any sodium vapor lamp with a spectrometer, we can observe two yellow lines backed by a dark region. It is completely emission spectrum of sodium. When electric discharge takes place, sodium atoms excite and de-excitation results the waves. So it results two yellow lines in the dark region. It is completely of emission spectrum. But we just made an arrangement that when we place the sodium atoms without any electric discharge, so sodium atoms are in the ground state and taking any continuous source, and whenever the continuous source releases continuous wavelengths, when they are falling on the ground level sodium atoms, sodium atoms absorbs the wavelengths of a radiations of particular wavelength, the required wavelengths. And when we observe the radiations after coming from the sodium vapor lamp, they appear as a continuous region backed by two dark lines backed by continuous region. So you can observe two dark lines in the same place as observed in the previous case, two yellow lines. So it is also, we can explain by taking the concept of Kirchhoff's law. Kirchhoff's law completely explains the concept clearly. Good absorbers are always good emitters. In the first case, they are good emitters. In the second case, they are good absorbers. So it is about the given video. And you can observe some questions that for a perfect black body, the absorptive power is A1, B.5, C0 and D8. So answer is 1. Second question, which one of the following is the best absorber of radiation? A. Quartz, B. Flint glass, C. Lamp black, D. Iron. Answer is C. Lamp black. Thermal radiations are electromagnetic radiations of short wavelength, longitudinal waves of long wavelength, electromagnetic wave of long wavelength. None of these. We cannot say it is of short wavelength or we cannot say it is of long wavelength. It depends on the temperature of the body, whose intensity is varying, but it produces some range of wavelengths. So that is the reason why we opted D. For more details, you can observe Modern Physics, G. Arul Das, and Introduction to Modern Physics by Arthur Beiser. Thank you.